Ciao guys and welcome back, I'm Luca and in today's video I'm gonna give you 10 reasons why you should choose a Lumix S1 over the S5. So if you are in a doubt which camera you should pick, this video is gonna be really helpful for you. The reason number one is the viewfinder. The viewfinder of the S1 has a way more resolution, and if you are following my channel since long time, you already know that I love to film with vintage manual focus lenses. So for me, when I have to grab a critical focus, it's really important to have a high resolution viewfinder. The reason number two is the presence of the XQD card slot. This is extremely important if you're working with photography, because you want to empty the buffer of the camera as fast as possible, so you're gonna be able to take pictures almost continuously. And if you're working with videography, we all know how reliable is this camera recording with this media format, so recording in the XQD card. It's extremely reliable. Actually, I never had the problem of a corrupted file while recording in the XQD card with the Lumix S1, while with the Lumix S5 and the S1H I had few problems with some SD cards. So if you need reliability and speed, the S1 with the XQD card is the good choice. I'm seriously trying to expose correctly this video. It's a bit cloudy, a bit sunny. In the Netherlands you never know what you get when you go out. So good luck in the color grading page today. And by the way, since a few weeks I released the loot pack for the vlog for the Lumix S cameras. So if you wanna spice up a little bit the colors in your videos, have a look in the description. There is a link where you can check the samples. And the reason number three why I prefer the S1 over the S5, actually even the S1H, is the presence of the lock switch. You cannot imagine how important it is to have this lock switch. Once you try it, you can never go back, because before you start to operate the camera, you can just lock every wheels and the touchscreen in the camera. So you're gonna be sure that you're not gonna change any exposure settings while filming. And for me, it's a big plus even over the S1H and the S5. So that's why I really love the S1. Oh man, vlogging with a monopod is so easy. The reason number four is, of course, the 4K 10-bit unlimited recording option internally with the S1. So if you're working as a documentary filmmaker or a business corporate filmmaker where you have interviews or ceremonies, you cannot imagine how good it is to have unlimited recording options in 10-bit. So you're gonna have a pretty good image quality, because you're gonna film in vlog and you're not gonna have the problem that you have to restart the recording after the 30 minutes limits that you will have in the Lumix S5. This is a big plus of the S1 over the S5 if you don't film with the external recorder. I don't know if you can see it, but maybe a storm is coming, so I have to be quick. The reason number five is the presence of the full HDMI port, because on the S5 there is the mini or the micro. I think it's the mini. I don't know about you, but I always break mini or micro HDMI cables with all the previous cameras. I always had to bring a couple of backups cable with me while using the external monitor. So if you work a lot with external monitors, the presence of a full-size HDMI port, it's a big plus in the S1 over the S5. Oh man, sunny again, almost summer. The reason number six is the bigger battery capacity of the S1 over the S5. Having a bigger battery in the S1, it's a huge advantage, because it's also sharing the same battery with the S1H and S1R. So if you're working with different cameras, it's always better to work just with one battery and don't stress about different chargers or choosing the correct battery while you have to swap it between the cameras. The reason number seven, it's a long list, eh? It's the IBIS of the S1. It's consistently better, in my opinion, than the S5. For example, I'm doing this vlog entirely on a monopod, so without a gimbal. And as you can see, I think it's extremely stable. And I mean, most of the time I just work handheld, and I never had a problem working with the S1. While using the S5 a couple of times, I noticed a little bit of a difference in the performances of the IBIS. So it's not a big problem if you work with a gimbal, but if you work handheld, you're probably gonna notice the difference between the two cameras because of the IBIS. The reason number 8, believe it or not, it's the body size and weight. For me, that I work most of the time handheld, because I don't think it's really necessary to work with a gimbal with this camera. I prefer to have a heavier body with a big grip because it's gonna give me more stability. But if you prefer to work with a gimbal, you will probably prefer the lighter body of the S5 because you're gonna be able to work for longer time before you're gonna get tired working with that big system. For the type of work and the style that I do, I prefer the size and weight of the S1. The reason number 9, it's related one more time to the body, and in this case I'm talking about the weather sealing. The weather sealing of the S1 is better than the S5 because the S1 is also freeze proof, and if you work as a documentary filmmaker or photographer, you never know where you're gonna end up working. Plus, I have a better feeling when I hold the S1 in my hands compared to the S5. I feel like the S1, S1H and S1R are better built than the S5. And finally, the last reason that it's pretty obvious is the opportunity to film 6K internally with the camera. And this is pretty huge, both if you like to reframe your videos, but also if you work with visual effects. I will show you some samples in the future what's possible to do with this 6K open gate feature. It's pretty funny, so stay tuned for when I will release that video. If you have any question, please write down in the comment below, and while going down, I would really appreciate if you can like the video to help me out. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope I'll see you next time. Ciao guys! Getting dizzy.